Lyme disease is not something many of us think about during these cold winter months, but with hunting season just ending, this is when some of the symptoms of tick-borne illnesses could start showing up. We're lucky to have with us hunting and fishing expert Babe Winkelman. You are on a mission to educate people about these tick-borne illnesses, and you have a center devoted to this.
Yes, ma'am. I was the first person to tell America about Lyme disease about 30 years ago on a campaign for a company I was working with, SC Johnson. There hadn't been any tick-borne diseases. It bounced off of America. Well, I got educated on it, and thank God. I've had Lyme disease myself 3 times, but I knew all the symptoms. I was able to get treatment, and if you catch it and get treatment right away, you can do fine. If you don't, and it goes into chronic Lyme, chronic Lyme right now is an epidemic in the United States. There are more people getting diagnosed daily with Lyme disease than there are ladies with breast cancer, to give you one idea.
Incredible. I don't think a lot of people know how big of an issue these tick-borne illnesses are. And you said there's six that can be deadly.
There are six of them that are fatal or can be fatal. Mm-hmm. Powassan, babesiosis, anaplasmosis, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, ehrlichiosis, not counting Lyme disease. And all of them are very, very serious. And we just said after 2 years ago, three of us, two of my daughters and I, all got Lyme disease on the same trip down to Missouri turkey hunting. I said, this is enough. My youngest daughter was misdiagnosed, and that's happening right now. They suspect 2 out of 3 times people are being misdiagnosed.
So, you know, this is such a big issue. As you point out, it's exploding. The number of people being diagnosed with these illnesses, the tick population is exploding. What can you do to prevent it and make sure you do catch it early?
That's a good question, because yes, you can. You can keep yourself and your family tick free. You have to treat your clothes with a product called permethrin. Insect shield, for example, you can send your hunting clothes in or send your everyday clothes in, and they will treat them for you. And if they do, they're good for 70 washings. They now sell permethrin in a can. You can treat your clothing yourself. But you have to treat the inside and the outside completely and then let it dry in. And you need to treat your socks, and you want to have a base layer. If you treat just the outside, you know, like a typical insect repellent, tick crawls up your leg, bites you, he's got nothing to stop him. If you treat the clothing all correctly, and then spray your shoes too, if a tick walks across 1 inch of treated fabric, first off, they will not bite you. Secondly, they'll fall off your stone dead within 15 minutes. A tick breathes only once every 15 minutes.
So that's key if you are an outdoors person. You're going to be outside. What about the people who are just hanging out in their backyard and might be exposed?
There's more cases of that than there is hunters having Lyme disease in America. It's in the suburbs of Minneapolis. They had a big article this year about the suburbs of Chicago and all the epidemic going on with Lyme disease in Chicago. Look at the eastern cities, Boston, Baltimore. They're all.
So we're running short on time, but tick checks, is that a key factor here that you should be doing, a key preventative measure?
Yes, and learn how to do it right. You know, if you get a tick on your body, what do? You grab it and you pull it off, don't you?
Probably. I've been fortunate not to have that.
Well, so would everybody, but that's what they do. And they're not realizing when they grab that tick and they squeeze it, they're injecting themselves with all of the pathogens and things that are in that tick, squirting it right into their arm before they take it off. So you've got to have a long nose tweezers. There's a special little tool called a tickies thing. And you just slip it underneath there and grab them by the head and pull it like so and take it out.
Okay. So that's all key information. There's a lot of key information. We do have to head to break. You can find a link to all the great information on our website. Just go to care11.com/shows. Thank you for being here, sharing this important topic with us.
Oh, thank you so much for the opportunity.
We'll be right back.